All the countries in the regions have opportunity to be part of global value chains. And if you look at the Asia countries, most of the countries also they're integrated well into the global value chains of the companies. And the way they do is, of course, they are through the investment, foreign direct investment. FDIs play an important role to make their countries as well as companies to be part of all their value chains in the world. And here in the regions, actually, there is an opportunity for all countries, but it all depends what kind of strategies the countries use. For example, there's a big difference between Central Americas and South America, for example, like Mexico in Central America or Brazil in South America. These two countries, which perhaps depends on these regions, but they have a different way of international strategies, I would say. For example, in the case of South America, which is represented by Brazil, has more put the emphasis on creating domestic value added, which is quite important. So therefore, they try to create linkages with their local economies. While in the case of Mexico, actually, interestingly, as I say, Mexico is more integrated into North Americas as well as the global value chains of the companies. If you look at the automobile sector, these two sectors both of them produce cars, but the way they're involved in the value chains are different. When it comes to Mexico, most of the input, for example, to be used to produce automobiles are imported from the United States and so on. So therefore, when you look at the export of automobile, the large part of export are accounted for by foreign input, which we call foreign value added. The foreign value added accounts for maybe 20-30% of exports from Mexico. While when it comes to Brazil or South America, it's not so high. Foreign value added accounts for little because their strategy is to more use local input. But then the question is, as long as local inputs competitive enough or very high standard, then there should be no problem. But not necessarily always such a case. Foreign input may be more competitive than the local input. Then in this case, there's also dilemmas for the countries. What they do, while they want to foster local linkages, at the same time, they want to increase competitiveness, but they may face restriction to increase competitiveness because of foreign input much more stronger, for example. So this always, they need a careful balance between to what extent the country should import as a foreign input, which integrated into the production, and also to what extent they want to use local input by forging strong links between big companies and particularly small companies. Therefore, all the countries, I would say, have opportunity to be involved, and all the countries have a different, perhaps, strategies. But I think the country should consider, given what kind of competitive advantages they have, and in which way they have to move, like Mexico ways, which is using more foreign input because they are very highly competitive, therefore the exports become so competitive. At the same time, they may lose the linkage with local economies. So then the question of how to link the strongest linkages with local economies. While in the case of South America, in like Brazil, you know, so while they want to increase more local input, but sometimes local input not necessarily competitive enough, which also reflected in the export of competitiveness. So therefore, actually, there is always a careful balance. What is important is while the government try to forge strong links so with local economies, with SMEs and so on, sometimes they'll also have to look at their also foreign input, foreign technology, or foreign management, so on. They are also very, how do you say, important ingredients for the competitiveness of the exports. So it all depends on the countries, I have to say, yes. But all the countries have opportunity to be a part of the global value chains. First of all, the investment, foreign direct investment, is a complement to domestic investment. Foreign direct investment is not a panacea at all. Domestic investment is important, and the foreign investment complements to it. So therefore, we should not put high expectations on foreign direct investment. Sometimes, we should also not expect the high, do not put high priorities on domestic investment as well. I think no matter where the investment comes from, investment is important. Therefore, we should look at both type of investment, domestic and foreign investment. Both of them are useful and should help the country's development, because these two different types of investment may complement each other, not be a substitute. I think this is very, it's going to be a very important issue in the future. Already it's important in the discussion of the APEC, for example, and in the discussions of the TTP. And so far, commercial relationship between Asia, Pacific, and Latin America is not so strong. But in the future, there is a potential through the agreement of the TTP or TPP, and also the strongest in the APEC. APEC is already delivers the concrete result, particularly on liberalizations and also harmonizations among the member states. I would say that both regions should learn each other. For Latin America, particularly, so what they could learn from Asia is development pattern in Asia. Through FDI, all the Asian countries developed the forming, what we call flying geese pattern. There is a lead geese, the two or three layers of the geese, which they fly together. Other times, the leaders transferred the know-how technologies in next level, and the next level transferred the next level, and so on. And everybody move together forward. This kind of development pattern is quite useful because it gives more, binding together of the countries. What I see in the region is, unfortunately, the countries work in isolation, not necessarily to bind together. And if the region want to develop, then I think Asian model quite useful and something to learn. In Asia, for example, United States or Japan, nowadays China plays an important role in leading the economic development of the region. Perhaps you may want to consider the similar situation here. So, so here you have a strong link with the United States or some link with Europe and so on. They may, could be, important, lead geese here. Between Asia and Latin America, both of them developing country regions. That is why I see there's something to learn each other. And I think it is also interesting, both regions have a kind of the regular session meetings to share the common agenda and also learn each other. I think that both of the regions have something to learn, because particularly developing Asia, Asia and the Pacific, so as it grew dramatically because of FDI. I'd say, and perhaps this region can do the same, but they have to use FDIs very wisely, very, I'd say, effectively. So that is, this kind of knowledge required for the government. Mm-hmm.